So you've mentioned the overtime and the leave issues. How else does this budget cut of $800,000 affect your ability to perform your duties as sheriff?
Taken back, and what I'd like the public to understand and know is that the sheriff's office is comprised of a lot of components. You have your detention component, you have your patrol component, your investigation component. We currently have the 911 component, and we have the sheriff services component. Using the jail for an example, the jail is understaffed. Yes, we have been averaging about 100 inmates. Things that I expect to be testified to due to classification, due to mental issues, due to keep aparts. And when I say keep aparts, defendants maybe that are brought in together that we cannot house together for either violent reasons or investigative reasons. We have a medical wing that we're unable to house or that we are unable to fully staff. We're having to observe under camera different things. Our staff is severely inadequate in the jail. The jail is a primary feeder component for the rest of the office, Your Honor. It's your jail feeds, it's our goal, and it's commonplace in practice of other agencies that I've served in, is your jail, they come in, it's make or break. So these young men and women come in, they begin their career in law enforcement. That's where they decide or they earn the ability to go to the academy. And so last year in 17 alone, we were only able to send one person to the academy, which ultimately translates to a less safe community if we do not have proper staffing to keep our jail safe. It's also a severe restriction on our officer safety, just due to not having the ability to have backup close, things of that nature. So going into the academy right now, we're unable to send bodies on a regular basis to the academy and have these men and women certified and prepared to assume roles in the patrol position in case it comes up. So ultimately, my short staffing in the jail affects my patrol operations because I don't have the certified bodies ready to insert in these roles when these men and women, and if these men and women leave to go to surrounding agencies, which they have for higher pay. It all boils down to if we do not have the adequate staffing in our patrol to have these men and women out being proactive, being seen, being able to have the ability to actually patrol instead of, as Mr. Holman said earlier, as just call takers. We have to, I've always said that an ambulance riding down the road is not going to keep me from having a heart attack. But a patrol car sitting on the side of the street may prevent a crime, it may prevent a burglary, it may prevent a robbery. And right now, we're just not able to be proactive. So that results ultimately affects our criminal investigations. Our criminal investigations or investigator staffing-wise are down. But yet our cases continue to crime, and it all relates to not having a strong presence on patrol, Your Honor. Drug investigations, our child molestations are up, our sex crimes are up. Some of these frauds, these are very time-consuming investigations. When you have to pull an officer out to attend a SANE exam or to attend a forensic exam and interview, and not even discussing the court time it takes for these officers and investigators to come in, these are times taken away from cases. And it ultimately translates to less service to our community. Our community is suffering. They need more of a police presence. We've seen a gross increase in retail crimes associated in that other area. I believe in equal and fair representation. I believe that our folks on the north and on the west deserve adequate protection. And right now, we're having to take these bodies, these men and women on patrol, and we're having to respond to calls. We can't just ignore crimes over in our business area, in our retail area, which is leaving ultimately places of our county exposed and unprotected. And to me, it's unacceptable. And these are types of discussions that unfortunately we didn't get to have during the budget process, other than when we presented to the board. Sheriff Services is another prime example. We do not have the ability with the increase of courts, with the increase of a new Superior Court judge this year, court cases will go up and court security plans dictate minimum staffing for officers. We do not have the ability to fully staff our front screening station with two officers at all times. That's a problem. And that problem that, that our county, I want our county to know and understand is that this is about protecting our county and protecting our people.